Time. Sarah, do you remember about the concept of time that I have told you in the previous class?
Yes, sister. You have told me about the time and you taught me how to read time from clock.
Good. Sarah, what is the time by the clock?
8 o'clock.
Good. How do you read that?
Since the hour hand is at 8 and the minute hand is at 12, that's why it is 8 o'clock.
So you remember what I have told you last time? Now I am going to tell you something more about reading time on the clock.
Okay.
As you know, Sarah, that the longer hand of the clock is called minute hand and the smaller hand of the clock is called hour hand. There are 12 divisions on the dial of the clock and they are numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Each division is further divided into 5 small divisions, as you can see here. When the minute hand moves from one number to the other, that is, in one division, it covers 5 minutes. That means, minute hand covers 1 minute when it moves from one small division to the next small division, as you can see here. Sarah, can you tell me how many minutes does the minute hand cover when it moves around the whole clock?
Since there are 12 divisions in the clock and in each division, minute hand covers 5 minutes, that means for the 12 divisions, the minute hand will cover 12 times 5 is equal to 60 minutes. So the minute hand covers 60 minutes when it moves around the clock.
Very good, Sarah. Can you tell me how much time does the hour hand cover when it moves from one number to the other?
It covers 1 hour. That means when the hour hand moves around the clock, it covers 12 hours.
Yes, in a day, hour hand moves around the clock 2 times. That means there are 24 hours in a day. There are 60 minutes in 1 hour. That is, 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. Minute hand is faster than the hour hand because minute hand takes 1 hour to move around the clock while the hour hand takes 12 hours to move around the clock, as you can see on the screen.
I get this.
Can you read the time here?
Yes. The hour hand is beyond 2 and the minute hand is at 4, showing 4 times 5 is equal to 20 minutes. Therefore, the time is 2:20.
Very good. Now, what is the time by the clock?
The hour hand is beyond 6 and the minute hand is at 10, showing 10 times 5 is equal to 50 minutes. Therefore, the time is 6:50.
Now you know to read the time. Sarah, look at the clock on the right. The hour hand is at 2 and the minute hand is at 12. The time is 2 o'clock or 2.
Yes, sister.
Now, when the minute hand moves from 12 to 6, it means half an hour has passed. Therefore, half an hour is equal to 30 minutes. Look at the clock on the right. The hour hand is beyond 8 and the minute hand is at 6. So the time is 8:30 or half past 8. When the minute hand moves from one number to another number, it is 5 minutes. As you can see here, the time is 5 past 2. That is 2:05.
Okay, sister, I get this.
Sarah, quarter in time stands for 15 minutes. When the minute hand is at 3, then the time is 1:15. The time shown on the clock is 2:15 or 2:15 or 2:15. Okay, Sara, now you can read time very well. But there are some more things that you should remember. When the minute hand is on the left-hand side of the clock, the time will read as the number of minutes to the next hour. For example, here the time is 10 minutes to 12, that is 11:50. Here the time is 20 minutes to 4, that is 3:40. When the minute hand is on 9, then the time is 1/4 to the next hour. The time shown on the clock is 5:45 or 5:45 or 5:56. Sara, hoping that you can now read the time very well.
Yes, sister.
Sara, can you tell me what the date today is?
No.
Today is 1st of July.
Sister, how can I read the date?
See, the number of days in every month starts from 1 to 30 or 31. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on till 30 or 31. There are 7 days in a week. And their names are days. Monday, first day. Tuesday, second day. Wednesday, third day. Thursday, fourth day. Friday, fifth day. Saturday, sixth day. Sunday, seventh day. Monday is the first day of the week, and Sunday is the last day of the week. The date on a calendar represents the day, the month, and the year. Do you get this?
Yes. But what is today, yesterday, and tomorrow?
Sara, today is the present day. Yesterday is the day before the present day. Tomorrow is the day after the present day. Consider today is Friday. Day before Friday was Thursday. It is called yesterday. The day after Friday will be Saturday. It is called tomorrow.
Now I understand about the days of the week. Sister, how many months are there in a year?
There are 12 months in a year. January is the first month and December is the last month of an year. The names of other months of the year: January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October, November, December. There are 7 months in an year, which have 31 days each. And 4 months, which have 30 days each. February has either 28 days or 29 days. An year which is completely divisible by 4 is known as leap year. It comes after every 4 years. For example, 2000 is a leap year because when 2000 is divided by 4, remainder is 0. That means it is completely divisible by 4. A leap year has 52 weeks and 2 days, while an ordinary year has 52 weeks and 1 day. The number of days in the month of February of a leap year is 29, and in ordinary year it is 28 days.
Okay, I get it.
What have we learned today?
Today, we have learned about reading the time from the clock days of the week, names of the month in the year, and about the leap year.